A couple of points that you mentioned, I just want to circle back to the glycated hemoglobin you mentioned. Mm-hmm. That basically fasting in the evening had a pretty robust effect in reducing that. And that's a marker, obviously, it's a marker of your long-term, you know, blood glucose levels.
Absolutely. They use that to prove diabetes drugs. You know, if a diabetes drug reduces hemoglobin A1C, that's how it gets approved. So it's a pretty powerful marker of risk.
So we're talking about, for example, metformin.
Yes.
Which is a very...
Any diabetes drugs has to move hemoglobin A1C down a certain amount before it can be approved. So if we can do this with a non-pharmacologic approach, with just changing when you stop eating and the fasting interval, I mean, that's pretty exciting.
Yeah.
And it's really exciting because the truth is all these drugs have side effects. They're not that pleasant to take. A lot of people simply discontinue them on their own. You know, so pills aren't necessarily always the answer. And this offers people a lifestyle choice.
And you mentioned that there were women that were involved that you had basically, they made changes. They started fasting in the evening and they also reduced their H1.
In our pilot studies, we were really focused on the feasibility and acceptability of it. So we didn't have any biomarkers. We were testing, could they do it? And how hard was it for people to do?
Okay.
So that was really a test of, because there's no point in recommending something if people can't do it.
Right.
And that's what we really focused on there in our personal pilot work, is just could they do it? And truthfully, they almost all did it, and they also all said they would recommend it as an eating pattern to their friends, or they would recommend the study, you know, which told us, okay, this is feasible and this is acceptable. And, you know, that's what we're interested in. Is not, you know, if it works, but it's like impossible to do, then it's not a valuable public health intervention.
Yeah. I was wondering, what I was trying to get at is how quick or how soon do you think it could change those
we don't have
levels? That would be very interesting to see if it's something that can be moved pretty quickly. Or, you know, if it takes longer. I don't know how quick these other, like metformin, works.
Oh, yeah. Most of them, the thing about hemoglobin A1C is since it reflects average blood sugar over the past 3 months, it takes about 3 months to move it. Even with a really effective intervention, since it reflects the whole last 3 months, it's like you're cycling through. You have to go a
red
whole
blood
3 months to see it.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Right. That makes sense.
Other markers may be faster, but because we already know that if you want to measure these markers, you want people to be fasting. So we know just even one night's fast makes a difference.
Right.
Right. If you do one night's fast, a lot of these markers will be flatter in the morning than if somebody eats breakfast right before they come in. You know, so you're really, what you're doing is you're extending the period of time where you have very low basal levels of a lot of these markers.
Right.